music. The music wakes you up on a Monday morning. We're always glad to have that song. What's that again, Cassandra?
It's beautiful.
It's beautiful. That's the name of it, too.
Damien Marley.
Oh, yeah. You knew that, too, right? Gosh. Too much music, but it's wonderful, wonderful indeed on this Monday. Good to see Dr. Andrew Ford, our dermatologist, and he is here to help us wrap our mind around another one of the skin conditions.
Let's say it together.
Granuloma annulare.
Together means both of us.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, good morning, Dr. Ford.
Yes, good morning to you and to the viewers.
Yeah. So not annular,
but annulare. Granuloma annulare.
What does that mean?
Well, it's inflammation of the skin, which tends to present in circles. And it's harmless, but it can be disturbing because it can last for up to 2 years.
Okay. Yeah, and it is caused by an abundance of white blood cells?
Well, that's more of a description of what you see under the skin. Mm-hmm. A granuloma is like a ball of inflammatory cells. Mm-hmm. So that includes white cells and other cells. Mm-hmm. And also, there's something called necrobiosis, where there's some dead cells within that ball of cells under the skin.
Okay, this is what it looks like here.
Well, that shows you some of the presentations. That's a presentation of just a little plaque on the elbow in a Caucasian, just a flat red area. And it can start out simply like that, localized as little papules or plaques on the elbows. You can have it on the top of the hands, or you can have it on the top of the feet, the dorsum of the feet.
Okay.
And sometimes it looks like the ringworm.
It can, but this also shows the papular form. This is on the elbows again, and they look red because this person's Caucasian. But the surface looks normal, but you just notice that it's pushing up from underneath the skin.
Okay, I'm glad you pointed out that was the elbows.
Right, so this is one from the internet. You can see now some of the oval shapes that are involved. But if you look at the edges of the oval shapes, you can see little papules or little bumps. Mm-hmm. So they come out initially and then they start to form circles. That's what the condition really wants
to
do.
So who is predisposed to getting this condition?
Well, it's predominantly seen in very young individuals, children, even in the first few years of life, or you know, teenagers, young people generally, but all age groups can get granuloma.
I read somewhere where women are more predisposed to it.
It occurs in women more often as well.
Why?
Well, we don't know why, because we don't know why you get granuloma annulare in the first place. But there are associations with other conditions. Now, this is one of the oval shapes. You notice that it's pushing from under the skin, and in pigmented skins, it tends to turn dark over the areas that are active, especially when it's going away and it flattens. Mm-hmm. It tends to become a dark area.
Is this contagious?
Fortunately, it's not contagious. This other photo shows you the nodular form, and this is a form that's a lot thicker and forms nodules on the skin that can range from 1 to 4 centimeters. This one, if you press the nodules, they can be a bit tender, but as you can see, it loves to affect the dorsum of the feet and other places. When it occurs in an unusual place, it can cause a lot of concern for the doctor and lead to what's called a biopsy, where you take a little sample out. Because, example, in an adult, recently it occurred in the sternum, just in the middle of the chest and in the middle of the back, and it's so deep and nodular under the skin, you get a bit concerned about what it
that
can be.
That looks quite different, that photo on screen.
Yes, well, this one is disseminated form in a very young child. This one is just the papule spread all over. So you can get this disseminated form sometimes if you get a sunburn, or it can occur just spontaneously. And this disseminated form occurs more in diabetics. There's a 1% association with diabetes. But in Barbados, usually when you see granuloma annulare, the patient is not diabetic.
There are a couple of things that fascinate me about the disease. One, that it is rare, and that it is basically harmless.
Yes, it is harmless, and it isn't the most common condition. But it's interesting that the inflammations that you get under the skin can arrange themselves in different orders, but yet they want to form circles. And you know that lots of things in dermatology form circles, and we're mostly concerned about fungi and different infections that are contagious. So the importance of knowing about granuloma annulare, mm-hmm. even though it's not common, mm-hmm. is that sometimes it can cause young children to be kept out of school. Mm-hmm. And you can imagine if you have a condition that's going to last for 2 years, being
Can't
kept out of school unnecessarily.
Years.
Sometimes people can miss months of school unnecessarily because they're misdiagnosed as having a ringworm.
Well, let me ask you this. Other than obvious embarrassment if it's in an open area, what are the symptoms for the patient?
Well, fortunately, it is usually asymptomatic, unless it is the nodular form, which I said when it's pressed, it can mm-hmm. cause some discomfort. There may be a slight amount of itching, but mm-hmm. other than that, it is totally harmless. So that's what makes it so disturbing to individuals. You just happen to notice something on the skin, and then it just stays there and doesn't go away. As I said, sometimes it can last up to 2 years, but mm-hmm. in lucky individuals, it can only last maybe a few weeks. That last young lady that we saw there, the child, already hers is starting to go away.
Okay. How easy is it to treat, having said all that you have?
Well, not knowing, in these cases where you don't know the cause of skin conditions, you usually treat the symptoms or the microscopic appearance. Mm-hmm. So we know it's an inflammatory condition, so we use, most of the treatments are anti-inflammatory. And the most common anti-inflammatory medicines used in dermatology are corticosteroids. Mm-hmm. So in this case, you apply a corticosteroid to the area. On mm-hmm. average, it takes about 2 months of applying it to the bumps to really make them go down. In individuals with skin of color, it gets flat and it turns dark. Mm-hmm. In Caucasians, it just flattens and disappears. The unfortunate thing is that you can get recurrences as mm-hmm. well. The treatments can also involve introducing that steroid through a needle subcutaneously. Okay. So you dilute it to the dilution, usually it's around 5 milligrams per mil. Mm-hmm. And if it's just a localized one, you can inject it, and in a few days or a week, it will be gone. But of course, if someone has multiple lesions, then many injections would not be a humane option. Mm-hmm. In some cases, too, you can take the steroids orally. But again, in a condition that's chronic, with steroids having side effects when taken orally, you have to balance the risk-benefit ratio for doing such a thing. In other cases where it's disseminated, they've tried light treatments. That's ultraviolet A treatments, along with a medicine that you take called Sorolin, and that has done some really good work. There are also some new medications that are steroid-free but anti-inflammatory, things like Elidel and Protopic. That there are other treatments that you use. So all in all, the treatments are mostly topical treatments, mm-hmm. or if it's just a solitary one and the patient is explained that it's harmless and they don't mind, they just keep it and just let it go away when it's ready.
Is seawater good for this?
Well, seawater won't hurt it,
but you
providing you can swim. I mean, it's important. Unless you have it in a cup.
Swim. My grandmother would say a sea bath fixes everything. You know. Yeah.
What about the possibility of scarring?
Well, usually the that's transient in that you get a discoloration, and mm-hmm. discolorations are a cause of grave concern in people of color. Mm-hmm. But fortunately, the discoloration goes away in a few months, so there's no permanent disfigurement caused by the condition, which is fortunate, considering some of the things we've talked about before. Mm. But you know that we've looked at quite a few things with oval shapes. We had looked at the ringworms as well. We looked at pityriasis rosea. Mm. We looked at psoriasis. And you know, you can get, we'd also looked at urticaria or hives. Mm. And all those things can cause circles.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What someone asked me recently about scaly patches just appearing on the skin and maybe eventually disappearing. Mm-hmm. Are you aware of what that is? Just by what?
Well, there are a combination of things that can be. Some people from their genetics can just tend to have dry skin, and that's called an ichthyosis. So you can get that. But the most common causes of scaly patches
in Barbados
that are circular would be eczema. There's something called nummular or discoid eczema, which appears in circles and affects the limbs most predominantly. And of course, we mentioned psoriasis as well. Mm-hmm. So they're the most common things that occur, even though they may itch a little bit because they're dry. But as far as itchy circles are concerned, that's That's a very common cause.
Wow.
All right, Dr. Cassandra.
It's not me who's giving the information. I'm just putting the questions out there.
But you pose such wonderful and probing questions.
Okay, what do you want? But now, this is helpful information. And just quickly, the levels of severity then are based on the number of lesions that someone would end up with.
Yes, definitely the number of lesions, but also the how deep. If it's subcutaneous, then that's problematic as well. And I guess one of the important things is that if you happen to go to someone who doesn't know about granuloma annulare, they may get concerned and maybe push their intervention too far if they don't know what it is. Right. So when in doubt, you need to get what's called a skin biopsy. If the doctor isn't able to make the determination just clinically, then a skin biopsy is important. Because, of course, there are other things that can cause lumps under the skin. Mm-hmm. But then it's the age group, because the lumps usually occur in younger individuals. But you can imagine an older individual having a lump, then we always worry about types of cancer or T-cell lymphomas. They're cancers that can be dangerous as well.
All right. Thank you very much. Our dermatologist, Dr. Andrew Ford, coming in and telling us about granuloma annulare. There you go. You can't say you didn't learn something on Morning Barbados. And you heard all about it this morning. So if you see that, remember, you are now armed with questions and you know a little better what to look out for and maybe to ask for a skin biopsy if you're not sure that it's ringworm or whatever. But thank you very much, Dr. Ford, and we look forward to hearing from you again. All right, happy Monday to you, and happy Monday to you as well. We're going to find out about iridology right after this. You know what it is?
Yeah.
You know what it is?
Absolutely. I've had it done.
All right. Well, we'll be back with Chantel Selk.